We've arrived at the final tool for this course, the Debug View Hierarchy. This was recently added to Xcode, and it allows us to dig into the visual hierarchy of an app while we're debugging. So to make things interesting, let's run the application, and I'm going to create a couple spiders. There we go. And then let's set a breakpoint in the add bug to view and jump back and drop into our breakpoint. From here, there are two ways to access the debug view hierarchy. The first is in the debug navigator, and we get to it by going to the debug navigator and then selecting this view hierarchy, UI hierarchy from the dropdown from this icon here. So we'll select it. And if we look at this unfolded list, we can see all the different UI image views, the bugs essentially, that are being created. And we can see where they're located. If we click on one of the items in the list, this is where it gets interesting. It brings us to this visual display of our view. So, you know, as I'm selecting on these are the bugs. If I click on this, it's talking about the buttons that we have, and there are the bugs. Now, if we click and drag this area, this is really cool. It explodes into a three-dimensional view of our view hierarchy. And we can see visually now some of the relationships between different elements in the view. And just like the list, we can select the different components. So I'll select this one. That's the UI navigation transition view. Select that one. Let me zoom out just a tad. There we go. That's one of the UI image views. There's a UI image view. That's the UI navigation bar background, and so on. Now let's go over to the controls that are available to us. Dragging this bar in the lower left-hand corner will allow us to increase and decrease the spacing between the components in the hierarchy. The next two buttons can toggle showing clipped contents and constraints, which does not do much for us here. Let's just leave it as is. And the third button from the left can flatten the view back into its two-dimensional form. Next are the viewing modes, which include contents, wireframes, and wireframes and contents. And let's just leave it as wireframe and contents for now. After that, we have these minus and plus icons, which are for zooming. And then if we click the equal sign, it will adjust the zoom so that it maximizes your view based on the space that's available to you. Now this last control, what it does is it adjusts the views that are visible from you going from the bottommost views on the left to the topmost views on the right. So if I start by dragging from the right and moving left, we should see the things on the top disappear before the things on the bottom do. And hold up, let me zoom out. There we go. And let me tilt it a little bit. And those are all the controls that we have on the bottom. The next thing that we can do in the debug view hierarchy is get diagnostic information about the components we've selected in the utility area. So you'll want to click one of the components, and then to display the utility area, make sure that you've toggled on this icon here. There we go. And here you can see information about the component's type, UI image view, its raw address, some state information, and a display showing its content. The raw address, hint hint, can be casted like we did earlier in the command line interface to gather more information about the component itself. So you can see how this would be incredibly useful, especially for games and other applications with a lot of things going in and out of the view. This is a really cool way to debug our application.